Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about fuel cell with the battery energy storage system. So this is a simulation model we developed for fuel cell with the battery energy storage system for DC microgrid. So this system consists of a fuel cell stack, and then the fuel cell stack will be connected to the DC bus or DC load via this boost converter. And this boost converter will be controlled by means of P2 MPPT in order to extract the maximum power from the fuel cell. So based upon pressure of fuel and air, and then here we have battery storage system. So the battery storage system will be connected to the DC bus or DC load, so via this bidirectional converter. So this bidirectional converter will be controlled by means of voltage PA controller, so for maintaining the DC bus voltage at 48 volt. So here you can see that this is a rating of fuel cell at a nominal operating point, so that it can generate when we have to operate that fuel cell at 24 volt. So it will be generate around 1.26 kilowatts. So it can generate maximum power when we are operating that fuel cell at 20 volt. So it can generate supply 100 amps, so totally it can generate 2000 watts. Okay, so it can supply maximum of 2000 watts. And then these fuels are going to be connected in the DC bus. So here we are going to maintaining the DC bus voltage or DC load voltage is 48. And then here you can see the input voltage we are going to be considered as 20 volt. And then the fuel cell rating is 2000 watts, right? So based upon this detail, the fuel cell power rating, maximum power rating, and terminal voltage of the fuel cell and the DC bus voltage, so we need to design that inductor and capacitor values. Okay, so next you can see that battery rating. So here we are using a 24 volt battery with the 100 Ah rated capacity. Initial SOC of the battery is here we are consider is 65%, and also here also we are doing the same kind of design, but here we are going to take the value of boost converter design and LNC, because so this battery also going to be used to for supplying maximum of 2000 watts. Okay, so here also we are going to use the whatever value we designed for this boost converter, so that value going to be used to for this this inductor, okay, and capacitor. And here you can see this boost converter, right? Boost converter going to be controlled by means of P2 MPPT. So P2 MPPT receive two inputs, fuel cell voltage and current. Okay, so based upon fuel cell voltage and current, we have to calculate the power, change in voltage, change in power. So based upon that, you have to design the duty cycle. Okay, so if you want to more information about P2 MPPT, so kindly visit our YouTube channel. So we already posted several videos about P2 MPPT. Okay, you will get the better idea on that video. So here the P2 MPPT will be generated the duty cycle, so that going to be processed via PWM generator. So PWM generator will be generated the PWM pulse, so based upon duty cycle, and it going to be control this IGPT in order to extract the maximum power from that fuel cell, so based upon the pressure of fuel and air. Okay, and then here you can see the battery is connected to the DC bus via this bidirectional converter. So this bidirectional converter going to be controlled by means of voltage control method. So for that, here we are measuring the load voltage. That load voltage going to be compared with the reference voltage. So here we are going to maintain the DC bus voltage is 48. So here we are compare with the 48 volt, and then it going to process via PA controller. So PA controller will be generate the duty cycle. So that duty cycle going to be process via PWM generator. So this PWM generator will be generate the pulse. That pulse going to be used to for control this two IGBT in order to maintain DC bus voltage at 48 volt. And then here we consider the load is we are taking as 1500 watts. Okay, that means V square by P concept, that means here we are calculating our value. So P equal to V square by R, and then R which is equal to V square by P. Okay, so that concept we are calculating the R value. So here load resistance is around 1500 watts we are consider. Okay, because if suppose we are going to operate this fuel cell at pressure, right, that when pressure of fuel cell and air will be equal to 1 bar, right, so it can generate maximum power of 2000 watts. So then it can supply the power to the DC load as well as, so it can used for excess power going to used for charge the battery. Okay, so when the pressure of fuel and air going to be reduced, right, so what happen, the power generation from the fuel cell going to be reduced. So during that time the battery going to be supply the power to the load in order to maintain the power balance in the system. Okay, so this system will be always having power balance, that means the source power which always equal to load power. Okay, and then here we have a different scope, right? So this scope is for measuring the load voltage, current and power, and this scope we are going to use to for measuring the fuel cell voltage, fuel cell current and fuel cell power, and then this scope we are going to use to for measuring the battery voltage, battery current and battery power. And then here the condition we are created, so here we are using step input block, right? So here we are having step time is 0.5, so initial pressure we are maintaining at 1 bar and then the final pressure we are maintaining at 0.01 bar. Okay, so because of this change in pressure, so fuel cell power will be reduced, right, from maximum to some level, right? So we can see the changes in the fuel cell voltage, current and power, as well as we can see the variation of battery voltage, current and power and SOC variation, and then we can see the response of load voltage, current and power. So now I am going to simulate this model. So before that I am going to open that scope of fuel cell, battery and load. So now I am going to simulate this model, so you will get the better idea on this. Okay, so initially from 0 to 0.5 seconds the pressure of fuel and air will be maintained at 1 bar, right, and then after 0.5 second the pressure of fuel and air going to be changed to 0.01 bar, right? So we can here you can see that initially the fuel cell voltage from 0 to 0.5 second, right, it maintained at 20 volt. Okay, and then fuel cell current is maintained at 100, and then here you can see that it generating 2000 watts. Okay, so generating 2000 watts already told, right, the load power is 1500. Okay, so here you can see the load power is maintained at 1500, load voltage maintained at 48 volt, and load current is maintained around 32.5 amps. Okay, so now we can see that the generation will be 2000, the load having 1500, so remaining power, right, so remaining power going to be used for charge the battery. So here you can see that this is a battery voltage, so this is a battery current, so battery current here is negative, right? So battery current negative means battery in charging mode condition, and also you can see the battery power, so battery power also in negative. So from that you can see that battery charging mode, so we can see the SOC of the battery. So SOC of the battery chain is increased from 65%, right, so start increasing manner, right? So what's the meaning, battery in charging mode condition during 0 to 0.5 seconds. When at 0.5 seconds, right, the pressure of fuel and air going to be changed to 0.01 bar, right, because of that you can see that the fuel cell voltage is reducing to 10, and then current is reducing somewhat, is around 80 amps, and then the fuel cell generating only around 800 or 850 watts. Okay, so because of that what happened, right, so there will be a shortage of power to the load, right? During the time what happened, that battery, right, so battery starts supplying power, right, so that's why the battery current change from minus direction to positive direction. Okay, and then power of battery also change from minus to positive, and also you can see the SOC of the battery is keep on decreasing. So what's the meaning, now battery is changed from charging mode to discharging mode because of change in pressure of fuel and air. Okay, and also here you can see that the load side, right, load side current is maintained at the constant, right, and the power also maintained at constant, so the load always get the power from the system, right? That means always getting power from the fuel cell as well as battery according to that condition of the pressure of the fuel. Okay, so this is working of this model. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.